Matata. What a wonderful phrase. Hakuna Matata. Ain't no passing craze.
It means no worries for the rest of your days.
It's a problem-free philosophy. Hakuna Matata.
So, we are over here, me and Timon. I'm just joking.
Yeah.
So, this is the beginning of the adventures of Timon and Pumbaa. The human versions, obviously. Right now, we're just having like a cup of coffee.
Dude, I'm a meerkat. What are you talking about?
I don't know this guy. He just kidnapped me from my house. But anyways, we are here at the Kingston Ferry Station. We're just waiting for the ferry to come. But yeah, we're having a good time. We had a good morning. Got to visit a friend. And, you know.
Don't you lie.
Shut up. Quiet, man. Anyways, so we're going to be waiting. And this is just the beginning of our adventure. So, So don't go away. We'll be back with the next part.
Don't go away, camera. Do not leave us.
The camera's right here and I'm holding it.
I know, but you're saying don't go
How
away.
How can you say this?
I'm just saying. You said don't go
I'm
away.
Just
so the camera.
Saying, man. This fool. I don't know him. I don't know this guy. Yeah, I mean.
Just make sure you don't go anywhere, camera. No running off.
Already, Timon. I'm supposed to be doing that.
Oh, sorry.
This fool, you hear that? Man. Anyways, we'll see you guys in a bit.
Twinkies.
When we get on the freaking Twinkies. Yeah. Yeah. That's another thing. We got Twinkies. And they're mine.
Nah, they're mine. See, told you.
We do got granola.
Oh, dude. This is the other good one.
We don't have pork chops on us. I just can't wait to, like, what? Freaking taste Leavenworth's T-bone steak and get 3 pork chops. I mean, take a look at my camera. Oh, hey, what's going on? That, a dog came in and just interrupted my video. But look at this.
I ain't got no fancy camera. What you talking about?
See, I mean, like, if you're gonna buy a camera, like, I mean, look what he got. He's got, like, professional. Oh, man, see? You see that right there?
I mean, where's my video thing? Oh, that's my video thing. Turn that on.
And he got a video thing. You see this? I'm so poor. Look at that.
There we go. I don't know.
This fool, man.
I mean,
red dot. And he doesn't even know what the red dot means. So, you know, this fool right here.
I didn't know the video part of this.
What?
I think it's, I don't know if it's actually, is it doing something?
Now I wonder if he's taking a video of me right now.
I don't know. I can't really tell.
It's how can you not thing. Know me?
Dude, it doesn't.
You bought that camera? He doesn't even know if he's gonna.
There's a blinking red light and there's a red dot.
A blinking red light. Okay, so you must be recording.
What? There's a blinking red light right there.
I don't know how to deal with this guy. Gosh. And I was playing the video that.
I gotta make sure it's doing something. I don't know what
that
is.
I don't know you, man. And what? What, dude? I can't even drive.
That's
I
why I'm
right
driving.
On that thing. Man. I should get a job like that.
You wanna work on a ferry?
Yeah, like if they have a fairy deli, I'll be making food.
They do have food on there.
I'll be making food for everybody. I'll be like, din din. Make sure they eat up. They don't want to be falling off the boat on an empty stomach. What do you
push
mean?
Them off the boat.
I'm going to have a bunch of Samoans throwing you off of the freaking ferry.
It's a nice RV.
Hell of a gas guzzler.
I can't even afford an RV.
Yeah, but it's a gas guzzler. You can't even afford the gas to put into the damn thing.
Do I know any Samoans who have an RV?
And look, we got lumberjacks. Look. I mean, what are those sequoias? We're on the ferry right now, and this fool. So yeah, we're moving. And I don't know if we're, dang, this is a fancy door right here.
Man, what was that?
I'm so fat. I can't make it up the stairs. I can't make it up the stairs, man. And we're upstairs. I just lost 50 pounds from that. It's too quiet. So, we're just on our trip right now. Finally got on the ferry. And I'm talking to myself, and everyone's just looking at me like I'm an idiot. So, yeah, we're heading to Edmonds. I'm not exactly sure where the frick we're going. But we're hopefully to heading to Stevens Pass so we can go to Leavenworth. So that's why we took the ferry. So we're probably going to be staying there until Sunday. We'll be back. Yeah, so we're pretty much good.
This is the quietest ferry I've ever freaking been on. You know what I'm saying?
It's like the middle of the day, so no one's really going to be on it.
Of course it's the middle of the day, but still.
I'm just saying.
Make noise. They got a snack bar.
Yeah, dude, of course they got a snack bar.
How come the fat guy always says that? Dizzy. Hear that? He got a little dizzy. Now he just did the Mari Haka. You could probably pull it off, can you?
Pull it off.
You know, the Mari Haka.
I'm too white for that.
Just because you're a cracker, it doesn't mean that this fool, man.
So I had to keep on going a whole bunch of stairs. What?
We can only save 20 children.
I don't know what he's talking about. He said something like we didn't say.
Five observers, 200 adults, 20 children. So we only get to save 20 children.
Oh, he said, okay, watch this. He said life preservers, 200 adults and 20 children. That's cold. It should be like, see, that's backwards. Look at that. Look.
Only 20 children get to survive.
The fire station number 4, lives preservers, 200 adults and 20 children. It should be women and children first. But anyways, actually my first time being on top of the ferry. And look where we're at. I'm coming, I'm fat.
Man, how does this guy expect me to go faster when I'm big?
Jonah and the whale. There's a storm coming. And Jonah's on the boat. And Jonah's gonna get eaten by the whale. Cause I was supposed to go to Nineveh, but no, I'm going to Leavenworth.
What you do?
What?
Jump.
How am I gonna jump? He's supposed to throw me off of the freaking boat. Ah! Now he's trying to throw me off the boat.
Hey, you want to swim? It's nice and warm.
I don't know how to swim.
Oh, let's do that. Come
on. That's a lie.
Jack on camera.
I'm getting seasick.
This is just beautiful.
Spokane. What? We're going to Spokane?
Dude, I told you, it's just the boat. The boat's name is Spokane.
I never heard of no boat named Spokane.
There's a Wenatchee boat too.
I haven't been on a ferry in such a long time.
You're stupid.
I'm not stupid.
We're on vacation.
Yeah. I'm gonna jump through a window.
Jump through a window? Hey, what are you doing? Oh. I thought that was an actual window. I don't know what he drew there, but let's walk away. I wish I had brought some of the YSA Award with me, but hey, I love you guys. That's why I want to share this adventure with you guys. Row, row, row your boat gently down the stream. Merrily, 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 I am getting hungry. Hey, look, dinner. Hey, you, come back. Hey, Can I have you for dinner? What about you? Okay, fine. Go ahead, fly. Hey, look, more lunch. Hey, you. Hey, you. You and you. Hey, can I eat you guys? I got a crossbow on me. Oh, wait, maybe they're gonna eat me for dinner. And it's getting windy. Run! Ah! Oh. This vacation. I didn't say the vacation was gonna go windy, but it is. Yeah. I know I'm not really saying anything, but I'm gonna wipe off the camera. But yeah, it's very windy. Here we are in Edmonds. We're like northern. We're like more north from Seattle, and you know, so we're on the road. We just got off the ferry. You know, and our adventure.
We're getting closer.
I am such a bad host. Should we turn this into like a comedy thing or what?
Dude, I thought it already was a comedy thing.
I don't know.
This whole time, what are you doing?
Hey, I wanted to eat those seagulls.
I know you did. I wanted to join you.
You were talking on the phone. No, I'm just playing.
I know, but I still want to eat them seagulls.
Should have got my crossbow.
What crossbow?
Exactly. I don't have a crossbow.
I do. You do? Not on me, but...
Okay, he's got a crossbow.
I got bow now, crossbow. Yeah, I got everything. I got definitely knives. I definitely got knives. In fact, I got one right here.
He's Irish. I mean, look at this beautiful country, man. I mean, like, I love farmland, you know? So, ladies and gentlemen, we just passed Monroe. I'm not sure if we're still in it, but, you know, we, wow, I just spit the freak. Anyways, we passed Monroe, as you can see, I don't know if you can see it, but we're passing some mountains and all that. Right now we're trying to look for a little church that, Aaron I saw a while back.
And, may not be there, I don't know.
Yeah, it may not be there, but, you know, it's always good to take urban adventures in some old abandoned places, you know what I mean? So, right now, I mean, look at, wow. Like, wow.
Oh, there it is. Yes, there it is.
Where? Okay, look. Pause, rest, worship. So we have to pause, rest, and then worship. Praise the Lord. Look at this. This is nice right here. I mean, Aaron said that you can only fit 15 people in here. I mean, this chapel. Huh? Is it okay if I can step in there? Ugh, look at that. It's got spider eggs on it. Dude, look at this. Guys, I mean, look at this. I mean, it's just... This is just like a small place right here. This is... Is there something in here that I should know about? I mean, look at this. This is like a small little church.
Oh yeah, not even... I thought it was... Yeah, you can only sit like four.
This is just nice, man. I mean, look at this. What's up, man? They got magazines in here. Is there somebody that owns this thing?
I don't really know. I'm pretty sure there's a Book of Mormon here somewhere too.
Really? Oh, dang, look at this. This is a good discovery right here, thanks to this guy. You know?
Well, that's just disrespectful.
Dude, what is this? You can write anything on here?
Yeah, I mean, if you want to.
Well, I'm going to write something. Put my pen on me. So, yeah. This is just great. Romans. The New Testament. So I'm going to write down. Watch this. L-O-V-E equals know I got bad handwriting now, but can you guys read that? I've heard this phrase a lot. L-O-V-E equals living on value emotion. So remember that. By Jonah Fa'a Muli. This is going to be kind of a... This is going to be kind of an emotional moment because, I don't know, just standing here, I just thought about my brother. So I think I'm going to write something down that he would say on this notebook. So... Rest in peace, Peter. Love you, bro. See, I guess you can also feel like the spirit in places like this, you know? I mean, look, we got scriptures right here. We got scriptures like Isaiah 4:10. Do not be afraid. God's here for you. Then we got John here. His mercy... or new every morning. So remember all this. I mean, these are basically written by people who has felt the spirit here. I mean, look at this right here. God's love, let love rule. You know? And then we got a John 3:16 right up there. It's just that the way they do this cross is just amazing, you know? Dude, I'm glad you brought me here, man. Like, I can feel like there's just some kind of energy, like, not like a bad energy, but like, just like a good energy where it's like, you know, it's victorious, man. This is nice though, you know what I mean? What's that? I don't know why they put Jay-Z on there, but if there's somebody named Jay-Z, then okay.
They're probably talking about the rapper.
Yeah, I know. Dude, do you see this right here?
What?
I don't know if you guys can see it, but we got like a witch star on here.
Oh, it's a devil's trap.
Devil's trap?
Someone's doing some satanic shit in here.
Okay, this is some crazy stuff, man. I mean, yeah.
It's cool though.
Yeah.
It's a cute little place.
It is a cute little place. Just have a moment right here. Here I am, just sitting on this little chapel here. But I'm going to remember this place, and I want to thank Aaron for bringing me here. This is just a nice place, you know. And glad this vacation turned out very well.
We're just at the beginning of it.
Just at the beginning. So this is why me and Aaron wanted to come together and have this adventure so we can share with you guys at home. You know, this is just great, man. I mean, I've seen like little chapels like this whenever we go on road trips, and just to see one, you know, things aren't more than they appear. I mean, this is just looking outside. I mean, look at that nice little farmland. But anyways, we don't want to take too much time, but I guess me and Aaron are just gonna head out for a little bit so we can make it to Leavenworth. As you can see over there, I don't know if you can see the mountains clear, but that should be the pass. That should be where we're going.
3 inches.
Choo choo!
They got airplane shit on there.
Airplane? Oh, whoa, hey, look at that! Wow! They're probably going to the Boeing company. What do you think?
Heading that way.
On the road again.
I just can't wait.
Waking on the road again.
Donkey, shut up.
What did I say about singing?
What kind of helmet?
All right.
Look at this country.
Life is the highway. I wanna ride it all night long. If you're going my way, I wanna drive it all night long. From all these cities and all these towns, and if I'm flagging it, so I don't know the rest of the words.
Yep. Is that it?
I don't know the words.
Climb every mountain, on every stream.
And that's where we're gonna end it. We're gonna know where the rest of it is.
Old Man River, the Old Man River. He must know something, but don't say nothing. He just keeps rolling along.
Cause I'm the driver.
Cause he got five on it.
$5.
That's all we got.
On the gas. We are broke guys from Bowlesbo and Port Orchard, the two towns that I start with P.
Yeah, the P places.
Yeah, P.
P.
Yeah, hey, is there a restaurant around here? I gotta stop at P's.
Nah, you don't get to P.
Why?
Because I'm the driver.
I gotta hold it. We'll be right back. This is not a good time right now.
Aw, yeah.
Now rub, you can do it all by yourself, baby girl, what's your name? Cause I'll buy you a drink,
yeah,
I can take you home with me,
yeah.
I got money in the bank, and like, ooh, 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 we're in the bed line, yeah.
Thank you.
So we're like somewhere around this area, right? See, there's Leavenworth. Just trying to find out where we can get to, but you know. So this is all the historical stuff. Let's go. Let's talk about history. Let's go to the history of this whole place, because we're basically in Stephen's Pass. So we're over here on the board. You're gonna see some of this history here. So Native Americans, the history of travel over Stephen's Pass, prehistoric travelers. Established tribes, the first travelers to cross the Cascade Range were the ancestors of today's American Indians. They followed animal trails and natural pathways, which eventually became established trail networks. Food gathering, trade, and visiting drew the Indian people from both sides of the mountains into the higher elevations over the passes. Huh, wow. Well, look, they got show the plants. Bitterroot, biscuit root, camas. Tool for a soft. I can't even read these things. And mountain huckleberry. Wow. Look how Indian fishing used to fish. Tumwater Canyon, Wenatchee River about 1910. Huh, very impressive. Well, the government packed trains, used early trails like this one, and parts of the tote road. Yeah, the tote road for the access of federal lands in Stevens Pass area. Huh, very interesting. And look at right here. Traveling with difficulties on... wow, man, I can't even... Man, I'm just messing up this whole video. Anyways, traveling with difficulties on early country roads. Your index. Let's see. Old road. Imagine traveling in this perilous route in turn of the century. Oh, wow. Heading east near Mount Index, about 1930. Very interesting. Rotary snowfalls, you know. Cascades. Near Burien Summit Stevens. So basically, I guess this used to be one of a lot of people's travel routes way back in the day. You know, the Native Americans, pioneers, you know, and that's where we're going to get into the history, into Leavenworth. You know, see, Leavenworth didn't really start out with, like, you know, it's just a city with just pioneers and all that. But it all started with the Wenatchee tribe, Cherokee, I think I got it right, but all those tribes. It's basically like a whole valley where they all used to fish and all that, you know. And then when the pioneers started coming, we're going to get to that. I don't want to spoil it. But let's just wait till we get to Leavenworth. Right now, we're just starting the whole world history of this whole place. So, right now, we are standing in the traveling route where these people, where they tell the stories on this board of where they used to travel. So, but as soon as we get to Leavenworth, we'll tell you the rest of the history. This is just interesting. But the adventure's not over yet. We're going to continue on. Nice increased safety rest area. Oh, look, sodas. Ha.
We only have like 30 more miles.
30 more miles.
So it's going to take us half an hour to get there.
You hear that? It's going to take us like a half an hour, like 30 miles. So. It's not going to be that far. Why? What do you suggest for where we're at?
So according to this one, we're right here.
And Leavenworth shouldn't be... Oh,
Leavenworth's
dang.
Leavenworth's right there. So we got, like, we're almost there. We're pretty much there.
Well, the adventure continues. So right now, we are just seeing where we're at right now, you know? But yeah. So I hope you guys enjoy most of the adventures that we're going to take with us. You're going to go with us, and we're going to have... We have tons of fun, so no worries. We're almost there. I know you guys been waiting, like, oh, why is so? It's like taking them, you know, taking them
Cause
forever.
Because
me?
Yeah.
No, this fool. See, this guy.
I'm doing speed limit, man.
Okay, he's going to speed limit. I'm just enjoying myself and just making these videos. But yeah. But anyways, what? I don't know what he said. Forget it. Hope there's some rams out here so I can just get a ram and run him over with it, right? And yeah, so anyways, we'll get back to it. And yes, I know he's behind me saying that I'm crazy, so yeah, we'll get back to everyone in just a few hours or in half an hour. What is he doing?
I wonder how dinosaurs like dealt with this kind of weather.
I think most of them didn't really care.
Huh?
I think most of them didn't really care.
Probably.
Probably.
I think the state fossil for Alaska is either the Gorgosaurus or the Pachyrhinosaurus. Yeah. Not sure.
So we were just told that this hotel, the Enzian Inn, was built back in the 1900s by a man named Bob Johnson. And basically, he was one of the guys who actually helped bring Leavenworth to its theme, to how it is right now, to its Bavarian look at this time. So right now, me and Aaron are going to go adventure right now. So, just going to go get something to eat, and we'll be right back. We are here in Leavenworth, where it was turned into basically a Bavarian town. Now, during, I would say, like, the 1890s, they were having many hardships during that time, trying to see if that, like, economic hardships, trying to see if they can bring it back together. But for most people, like Bob Johnson, for example, as we were informed, that he was one of the men who brought Leavenworth as its theme now. Hey, look what I found. I found lunch.
Tasty.
That's what I said. So this is our second day of day two at Leavenworth. So we're here up here having breakfast. But look at the food. That's plate number one. Okay, never mind on the second plate. I don't think it's going to work. So, I'm already satisfied. The thing about, you know, this German style of food. Look at my plate now. Well, I got to finish that chocolate biscuit, you know. One of the things that they do here in Leavenworth, I think it's kind of traditional to the German culture, but you know, that was actually an outstanding performance.
Yeah, that's pretty cool.
You know, and that's one of the things that we call the picture of what's his name, Bob Johnson. So yeah, so I hope you guys enjoyed that. And we're gonna continue on with our adventure. All right, stay with us.
Yeah, so we are walking down. What are you looking at?
Alright, so I just pulled this out of my pocket.
Yeah?
Fortune from like, I don't even know how long ago.
Okay.
It says, you will be traveling to distant lands for a fun time.
Oh, shoot. Yes, sir.
Oh, man. What a fortune. And it came true. Look at my shirt. So, we're still continuing our adventure, you know? Yeah, you can see the whole town. Some of these stores do not allow some videos and pictures in their side of their store. But one thing you guys gotta understand is that a lot of stores here in Leavenworth, most of their stuff is valuable, especially with artists. So, So we're just like walking around and like going inside stores, and they got a lot of nice things inside their stores, and you know, this is one of the things that attract
we're
a lot of.
Buying everything we can.
yeah, everything we can. Got a mood ring, got the shirt, you know. He bought something for his mom. He's a mama's boy.
I bought something for my dad too.
Huh?
I bought something for my dad too.
Oh yeah, he bought something for his dad too, and you know.
And my sister.
I bought some stuff for my nieces and nephews. Trying to figure out what I should get for mom and dad, you know. Just doing our thing. But yeah, so. And here we go racing. Eat my dust. Look at their apartments. There's more places to be explored. Hey, look
at you with your
the Upper Valley Museum. That way! Right now we are in the Upper Valley Museum just checking some things out. So there are certain things that we can't film, but we're gonna just cruise around and see what we have here. So Aaron's gonna get his camera out. But look at this museum, you know. And then we got some brochures. Swing there for just a little bit. As you can see, there's a lot of big history over here. You know, just certain things. This is one of the pictures way back in the day, how Leavenworth used to be. You know. Aaron. The great history about the Great Northern Railway. It's pretty good, you know. Charles F. Leavenworth, who named the town. See him right there? That's his name is Captain Charles Frederick Leavenworth, the guy who actually named this town when the whole thing was being built. So was born in October 1845. Union Army 15 wanted to serve the Civil War. That's very interesting. You know. And during that time, got some ancient artifacts. And look at that typewriter. Computer. These are all the office items like before computers came out. They didn't use any electronics or anything, so they had to use all of these artifacts. You know. This is just interesting. Lance Davis Sawmill. They started in farms. See, like I said before, Leavenworth did not start out as like pioneer people. It all started out when the Native Americans were here on this land fishing, you know, gathering furs and all that, whatever they had to do to survive. And that's how Leavenworth started. Cherokee, the Wenatchee tribe, lots of tribes. These are like the old style cameras. Not really camera, but like developer. And these are artifacts from way back. Things that have been cherished and kept as treasures. And these are very important to keep, very important to show people. Let me just show you a quick picture of Captain Charles Frederick Leavenworth up close. Nah, there he was, the guy who started it all. That is one nice piano. Just show you some pictures. Here's the start of the first people, the Wenatchees. All the Native American tribes that were here once, who lived in this land as they were traveling
through the Stevens Pass. And these are taking place of 1890. This is interesting. And this is how Front Street looks today. Thanks to all the people way back who brought Leavenworth back to a town where a lot of people like to come here. And people who say they love Leavenworth. And these are one of the places. Leavenworth is a place that everyone wants to go to. So this is one neat thing that I think you guys will enjoy seeing. Old time stove. That's how the stoves looked back then, and we're looking at one right now. So we just visited the, just got out of the museum, and we just found this river like right down the cliff from the museum. So me and Aaron are gonna try to see if we can get down there, and see if we can get a closer look. So here we are. I'm the king of the world. Oh, what are you doing? And I'm standing on a rock, and he's just playing with the water. Nice place, though. It's a cool shot.
What's cold?
Oh, that's cold.
Get it? That's cold.
Look, God gave us a sign. Yeah. Hey, look, it's a nice beach. Putting the river to work. Man, it looked like someone had been attacking this with a tomahawk. 1902, the Lamb Davis Lumber Company purchased Timon lands from around Lake Wenatchee and built a sawmill in Leavenworth. By 1905, the dam was built, creating a mile-long mill pond stored logs after being floated down the Wenatchee River. Portions of the dam's rocky remnants stretched across the river in front of you. And there it is right there. That's got a nice beach to it, though. You ready to skip a rock or what? Clay got a rock in your hand.
Oh, no.
Oh. And look, they got a rock stairs. I love Leavenworth.
I know you.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and I almost tripped on the freaking rock. Now we're going to the beach of the river. Then we're probably gonna swim in it, skip a rock.
Woo! This is nice.
Man, look, these people are so lucky to live here. And there you go, skip a rock. Two times, good job.
That was with a non-flat rock.
Oh, it wasn't a... Oh, my bad.
So, it wasn't supposed to skip.
Oh, okay.
But it did anyway.
Yeah, it did anyway. Now we're chilling on the... That's funny. We got some benches over here. I'm gonna sit down. Nice country. Thank you, God, for the nature. Amen. I hope y'all still enjoying this adventure with us. I think we found gold. Well, Aaron, I want to see if you guys can see it.
The shininess in there.
I don't know if y'all see anything, but...
That's rock and water.
It's just rock and water, I think. But we're not sure. But there are many mysteries to solve. We see pioneers come out here in for many reasons in Leavenworth. One of it is furs, the other one was gold. So you may never know. They might be in the water. I don't know, in the mountains or caves. I don't even know if they have caves here, but hey. Hope y'all are still enjoying the adventure. And I think we're just going to look for gold. So, yeah. Looks like there's something in the water right there. Just a rock. What is this? It's like a stone circle or something. We'll find out.
You should have turned around for vehicles.
Oh, turn around for vehicles. Oh, never mind. I just wasted my film on this crap.
Look at that, turn around for vehicles. That's right.
Never mind, we're just going to continue down the trail. Right? Oh, whatever. Thanks. Bicycles on trails only. Slow speed only on parking and bicycles. Fishing only when state regulations permits. Don't clean fish within this park, please. Pets. Leash and control pets. So all pets must be on leash. So watercraft, launch boats, wildlife, look and enjoy, but don't feed, harm, or approach. So that kind of bummed me out. Cause,
by the way, crossing bears are present.
I want to... What did you say? Oh, well, hey, look at this. Caution, bears are present. So I guess I'm going to be a meal today. You know, I got a lot of meat on me. You know. Anyways, I'm getting kind of scared. I'm scared. I can't even eat any deer over here. No, I'm playing. I'm playing. For all you animal lovers, I'm not going to eat rabbits or any deers. Okay, whatever. Moving on. There's our map. And there we are. Please, bears, don't come out for dinner.
You always gotta be videotaping. Can't just take a simple photo.
Hey, look, there's a playground. Let's go play in the playground. Wait, there might be a bear. No, I'm playing. I'm gonna be kind of stupid right now.
Kind of uncomfortable. I forget it.
This fool.
You did it, son! You did it! Oh my gosh!
What is he gonna do now? Oh, you're cool.
I know, right? I could run down slide. Wait, come.
I think I'm gonna break it.
There go the river. Restrooms.
Throwing down memory lane.
Now I'm playing.
Now leave your garbage. Bears have been seen in this area. He's afraid.
No, I'm not.
He's a baby.
No, I'm not.
Look at Bear.
Where are you going?
Down the trail.
I'm fat. There is no bear.
No bears, please.
Follow the leader, and you're taking a picture of me.
Bridge.
On that bridge. The bridge of Casadoom. Oh, sorry. Hey, look, it's a palace. Wait, what is that?
My crib.
That's your crib?
My crib.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, they're building it for me.
You built that whole thing? Yeah.
Yeah, I do.
German style. Let's
Let's walk the bridge.
Be careful, there is a troll on this bridge.
There's no troll on this bridge. Down by the riverside.
Down by the bay where the watermelons grow.
Back to my home.
I
then I go, but if I do, my mother will say.
I don't really know what she'll say, but she'll say something.
I think if someone would say, bring back some frogs so I can cook them. Down by the bay. And the song just went down.
4:30.
It's 4:30. We don't want to get dirty. Oh, whoops. I almost dropped my camera into the water. And we're coming to the end of the bridge. That's the adventure of the bridge. Stay with us, and we'll be right back.
Ah.
What?
Ah.
And we'll be right back for the second time.
Ah.